Hello, everyone. My name is Indy Smith. Welcome to another week of Reality of Love. I know I'm here. There's, you know, an empty chair, but it won't be empty for long. It's a lot going on, you know, behind the scenes. And Mr. Green is actually in the building and he's on his way. So I decided, you know what? We always, you know, we try to start on time and it's a little after, so I don't want to keep anybody waiting. I'd like to thank, oh my goodness, Ash Cash, he just like opened up a whole window of thoughts for me when we were talking about finances and relationships, and you don't really think about it, but it pretty much put me in a new positive, responsible perspective. So I just wanted to shout him out again for being supportive and coming through, you know, when Len wasn't here. The topic tonight is good. Shout outs to Ishe because, you know, she found this email and we have callers. They're waiting to get in on this topic and we have this. Are we going to, Nadia, are we still going to like do the Nadia? Shout outs to Nadia because, girl, I have experienced the same thing. Not quite the same thing. But the topic for tonight is, okay, so Lenny received an email from a young woman that tried some new tricks and positions and, you know, she was doing some new stuff with her man in the bedroom. And apparently he needed to know how, what, when, why she's doing all this new stuff. A bunch of us are up in arms because we don't think that she should have been questioned. But now that I think about it, why not?
Well, that's her husband.
I mean, that's her right, exactly. That's her well, husband or not, my thing is if he's questioning why she's doing this new stuff, where she learned it from, there might have been a conversation or issues like in their relationship anyway. That's what I'm thinking. Like if you're questioning that, if you don't go immediately to damn baby, like where you get that, like what's going on, like I like this, if it's why are you doing this, where'd you get that,
what if it's a little bit of both, what if it's like I like
this, I mean, I think it's the tone. You all don't see her, but Ishe is here. There's Mike there, babe. I think it's the tone. I think it's the person's tone. And this could be for women too. Your man comes in and he's like, turn over. And he don't ever want you to turn over. You know, I would wonder like, okay, so why am I turning over? What excited you? But I would think, all right, what porn you been watching without me? Without me. We supposed to do that together. But you know, I'm just saying. So there's some people who are upset because some people don't feel like she should have had to explain. I think if you have a question, there's no such thing as a dumb question. If you don't answer it, I would question that also.
But would you be skeptical? Like, would you, I mean.
If I have trust in my relationship, I'm not going to be skeptical.
Because it's the men who are saying.
Right.
It's not really the women.
Yeah, there's no women not trusting. No. Exactly. There's, right now, the main callers, the main people who have the side eye are the men. So, fellas, what's going on in your relationships? Hit us up. Like, hit us up and let us know your thoughts about this. And we're taking callers now. Do we want to wait for Mr. Green?
Nope.
No? Anybody?
They hung up. I could take this one.
Okay, so we might have a caller calling in about this, but please hit us up. Let us know your thoughts, your concerns about it, because we have some.
But do you have?
Let me see. Derek. Derek made a comment. That's her husband. If he asks, she should explain. Okay, Derek, I get that because I feel like as a spouse, that position. But what if the relation? I'm talking to Derek. What if the relationship is? I don't know. How do I want to explain? What if it's not doomed, but what if there's some funky stuff going on in the relationship and you know, you're in therapy and you're trying to make amends. There you go.
Yeah, I am.
There
yeah,
you
I am.
Go.
Yeah, I am. I know you've been waiting.
Late as ever. Yeah, what if there's something funky going on in your relationship and you're trying to make amends and she decides to come in and turn it up a bit and now he's thinking sideways. Like, I don't need to explain that to you. Like, I'm trying to make amends. I'm trying to bring something so we don't go down the divorce path. So, Derek, I understand, but the tone of this is like, you got to answer everything I say. I don't know.
Yeah, I read about that. Yeah, yeah. That's a little funky.
Yeah.
I agree. Hey, look, like I said, if you come to play and it's turned up and I see how open you are to doing certain things, then...
Do you have no questions?
No, nah, I mean, because I'm going to do something now.
Okay, so... You're trusting.
I would have been doing something a long time ago. But so
you could
she's,
have been turning it up a long time ago.
Yeah, I mean, because you know what? Look, especially and to all the couples who have been together for a long time, things can become mundane mm-hmm. and monotonous mm-hmm. and even boring, as someone just posted up on Facebook a little while ago. So I think you have to be willing to explore and do certain things mm-hmm. to keep the excitement in the relationship.
Right.
And if you've been together with this person for a mighty long time, then you need to definitely want to, you know, just bring something else to the table. And it shouldn't be any question. Mm-hmm. I mean, not unless it's bondage. I mean, if it's bondage.
What's wrong with bondage? This sexy bondage. I don't know who she was, but somebody called in and spoke about 50 Shades of Grey. I didn't read 50 Shades of Grey. But from what I understand, it's total domination and submissive and all that stuff.
Nothing for you, huh?
Oh, definitely something for me. I can, you know what? It is sexy to be submissive to someone you trust.
Are you an exhibitionist?
A little bit.
Mm. Can you define that for those who may not know?
Take it off and who cares who sees? No. Not in the street.
Right.
But like.
Right. But you don't care if you're in your home.
If I'm in my home, I was in a home.
The window is open.
Yes, I'd had no curtains up. I purposely didn't put like curtains up in one area. It really made my mother twitch.
You on the ground floor or something?
No, I was on the 14th floor.
Was there other buildings around?
It was right across. Yep.
It would have been Peeping Tom City, I guess.
I guess so.
Wow. And you just didn't care.
I don't care.
You walk around.
Yeah.
In your birthday suit. Yeah. Gotcha.
Look, I ain't murdered nobody in there, so I don't have nothing to hide.
I hear you. Okay. Well, there you go. I mean, and you have to be open to certain things. And you should be really comfortable with a person if you've been with this person for quite some time. So I think... you got to do what you got to do.
Well, I was saying that, like, if the guy, the woman that emailed you, if her husband wanted to, had all these questions, it sounds like they might have had some trust issues.
Yeah, I mean, it definitely falls in trust, insecurity issues. And maybe there could have been a thin line of other things. There was a lady who I just played back a little while ago. And we didn't play back the entire conversation because I wanted to wait.
That's Nadia.
Nadia.
Right.
By the time the end of the conversation, I think I called her a different name because that's how deep I was thinking about what she was telling me. But I think we got up as far as, you know, she told me that she had, I don't know if she knew this guy from a long time ago mm-hmm. or if she simply engaged, you know, met him online, like on Facebook.
Right.
And...
No, I think this was her old friend.
An old friend.
I think so. It was an old friend?
It was an old friend. Okay. All right, so basically, you know, they started having phone sex. So, you know, it's so funny. Now, she's been married
Nadia's
for over
married.
20 years.
Right. Okay.
She's married over 20 years.
Okay.
So, obviously, again.
So, you know, that brings up something else for me. And, I have relationship conversations almost every day. I'm really gonna have to keep a journal. I'm not exaggerating, because I get some amazing quotes. I have great conversations and I forget who they're with. But I was it here we were talking, is there such thing as the one that got away?
Yeah,
the one that got away. And I think sometimes we pick people who aren't on the same page as us, and we keep complaining about our needs being met. Mm. Nadia, I'm getting back to you. And then, you definitely don't want to marry that person. It's one thing to be in a relationship with somebody and you're not evenly yoked. It's another thing to marry someone you're not evenly yoked with, because there's always going to be conflict. And I think, oh my God, like last year, like many, many moons of Reality of Loves ago, I think we were talking about arguments. Is it healthy to argue all the time? Remember that one? Yeah. And I was like, yeah, there are healthy arguments. But when you're constantly fighting and bickering and not on the same page.
Not good.
10 gallons and a pint. Shout out to TD Jakes. 10 gallons and a pint. And there's nothing wrong with being a pint, but you need to be able to pint. 10 gallon, you're never going to fill them up. 10 gallon, pint is too much. There's not enough.
Wow. That's deep.
So I'm excited about Nadia's this conversation, because I've been there, but kind of in a different way. I wasn't cheating on any. Oh, sorry, Nadia. Nadia, girl, you was cheating. I wasn't cheating on anybody, but I know what it's like to be just wet all over spiritually for a man.
Wow. Okay. Hey, Vito, when you get a chance, could you rewind that phone in the back? Wow. Okay. Wet all over.
Phone in
the back. She kind of made my eye tear on that one. Wow.
Lenny, can you imagine if a woman, I'm going to throw Lenny under the bus right now. If there is a lady out there and you have spoken to Lenny Green and he has spiritually made you wet all over, I want you to call. What's the number? 1-855. What is the number?
4-Lenny-G.
Hit us up.
I'm not even going to engage in that one, but getting back to Nadia. I mean, obviously, there was a lot of things going on in that relationship. And over 20 years in, you know, she needs it turned up from where it is. And my thing is, you know, not trying to take sides, but if I had to, I mean, well, did he turn it up? Obviously, he hasn't turned it up either.
Right.
You know, before this conversation happened with this guy, this friend, you know, because I think you can kind of tell, at least I can kind of tell, when things are not right, things get really interesting.
You can feel it. You can feel the relationship. When you've been with, even if you haven't been
if
with
I'm listening,
them.
No, but if I'm listening to a couple and I could just tell, you know, things are just not right in that love paradise. Mm-hmm. And I hate to say it, and I'm not trying to forecast bad days ahead, but it.
And she's. I feel like I'm spilling the beans until people hear the conversation, but I feel like she still speaks to this person.
I got to step away for a moment, but I'll be right back.
Are we playing Nadia, or am I waiting for you to play Nadia?
No, you're going to play Nadia. Nadia was the first one. Just rewind that one right there. It's right there. It's that one. Yeah.
Wow. I'm excited.
So you listen to Nadia, and it's pretty in-depth, so I'll be right.
And I will definitely we're not going to play Nadia first?
Hi, what's your name?
No, it's up to you, babe. I need these. Reese? Okay. Hi, Reese?
Yes.
Hi, this is Indy Smith. You've called into WBLS, but it's the Reality of Love with me and Lenny Green. So we want to know your comments on this topic. Do you know the topic?
Yeah, I know the topic.
Okay.
Am I on the radio, though?
Yeah, you're live right now.
Oh.
Go in, my love. Oh, did you not want to be exposed?
Okay. No, I don't, she should not tell him why, where she gets, you know, like her bedroom skills from, like, because that's none of his business. I mean, you know, like, do he tell her, you know, like, hey, you know, like, where he get, you know what I'm saying, like, his, you know,
right,
his lip skills from?
Well,
you know,
okay,
like
I don't think
I mean,
he had.
Go down on her, you know?
I love it. Okay, wait, I don't think, from what I understand with the email, I don't think he was doing anything. And I think this sparked a new interest in the bedroom for them. So it's kind of like, okay, you know, if I don't spark this, I'm going to stray. So let me get this turned up. And I guess it took him aback because she hasn't been acting like this. So I personally think there might have been trust issues in the relationship before.
Well, no, that's whack. No, that's absolutely whack. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Like, please, because she could have been watching some black girls on porn.
Right.
So, right. You know, like, it's nothing. It's not that serious. You know what I'm saying? Like, it could have been from anywhere. It could have been from a previous relationship. You know, like.
Oh, you open with that. So let me ask you. So if, okay, are you in a relationship?
No.
Why you stutter? You lying? Are you lying? You lying. Mm-hmm. Okay. So say you're with someone and let's say it's 7 years. What is that? They call it the 7 year itch. Is it like 7 years, y'all?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
7 years and it's just not. You know us women, we get in our heads sometimes. If we don't get the right look, the right hug, the right attention, we'll get insecure. So say that's going on, and then your man comes in and he just gives it to you, that attention, or he's just doing extra, and it's extra for maybe 3 straight days. Do you know what I'm saying? Are you going to question him? Would you question him?
Would you?
Would you? Yeah, Lenny's here. Lenny is back. He wants to know. I want to know too. Would you be honest too? Would you question him, or would you just say, "Oh, finally, I'm getting some attention." You know what I'm saying? You know, you a woman.
I don't think I would question him, but I think I would. You know what I'm saying? Like, have a question mark in my head though.
Okay.
I would definitely be like, "Okay, oh boy, since you're doing that now, I want that." You know what I'm saying? Like, often.
Oh, okay.
I'd give it to you often,
that, you know,
baby.
Like, all along.
I would give it to you as often as you want it.
Oh.
All right. Ooh. You should have been doing that, you know what I'm saying, like, all along.
What you say?
You should have been doing that all along.
Well, you know what?
Why I had to wait.
Mm.
Well, you know, sometimes you got to learn your partner, too. Mm-hmm. Because sometimes if you do things too quickly, you may turn them.
7 years, though.
Well, I gave her a scenario.
Oh, 7 years. Okay.
I gave her a scenario that it's been 7 years because she doesn't agree that this man needs to know where his wife learned all her tricks.
Right.
But I'm saying, okay, there's something going on that maybe she's not getting it. She wanted to turn it up a bit. Mm-hmm. And he's wondering, he feels insecure. There might be trust issues. So I gave Reese a scenario, in all fairness. What if it's been like 7 years, she's with her man. I think she got a man, but she lied and said she didn't. And, you know, he all of a sudden is giving her this attention. All this stuff that made her fall in love with him, she's getting again after 7 years that she hasn't been getting. Would she question him?
Well, yeah. I mean, if she wasn't getting it, she would question him probably. But you know what? In a scenario like me, it starts, you know, pretty much from day one. You know what I mean?
So you're saying how you go in is how you're going to finish. If you always
you start,
giving it
is
good,
the way you finish. Well, yeah. I mean, you give your best performance not some of the time.
Okay.
All the time.
Fair enough.
I mean, you should.
Yeah.
And we all have down days. Don't get me wrong.
I agree.
We have down days. You know, we're all human. So you're not going to be 100% all the time. But, you know,
right.
90% of the time, you're going to be good.
Or want to be good.
Right.
Or you want to be good.
Yeah.
And you know what? And as we get older, I think we become more secure. So even if you know that you can't perform to the level that you may need to perform at, that's where those sexual toys come into play. Right? Or honey, or chocolate, or something.
Or some handcuffs.
Role play.
Thank you. I love role play.
Easy with the role. See, I'm a little scared when you ladies say role play.
Because Honey Blonde comes out often.
Who?
Honey Blonde and some shoes and, you know, like,
that works.
All that comes out very often.
Yeah,
and
bring that.
You know what? I am so for that. I think if I give this to couples, I think you should cheat every once in a while on each other, but cheat with each other on each other. So you change it up. You put on a new wig. Fellas, you change up your outfit.
That's
you act
blonde.
Like a new.
That's Honey Blonde. Yes.
Yes. Honey Blonde. Okay.
You know, there's a song that my boy Neil Solo is Dwelle. Wrote and sung. It's called Cheating.
Mm-hmm.
And at first, everyone was getting mad at him, but he was cheating on his girl, with his girl.
With his girl, exactly.
That's what's up.
I love it.
That's
would be Halle Berry.
That's sexy.
It is
Beyonce.
Sexy. I agree.
You can be somebody different every day. Love it. Oh, Reese, thank you.
Thank you for calling, babe.
You're welcome.
Have a good weekend.
You too.
It's a whole bunch of paper going on over here.
You know, there's a... There's going to be, the Circle of Sisters is coming up in New York. For those of you who may not be in New York, October 19th and 20th at the Jacob Javits Convention Center. I was just informed that I'm going to be a part of a panel. I'm actually going to be on a panel.
Nice.
Which is a little bit different for me. But I can't wait to be on a panel, not to be the moderator, not to be the guy who's asking the questions.
Oh.
But the questions being asked to me, but it's not only going to be me.
That is so you. People call up here and ask you anything.
Not really. Not a lot. People don't really ask me. They ask me questions on occasion, but to be in this position is going to be pretty interesting because I heard two of my other panel mates will be Lamon Rucker, ladies. And Eric Benet. And they're going to add a couple of more. It's going to be moderated by Tamar Braxton.
Oh. I love
it. Why you laugh?
It's going to be great. I can't wait to be there.
I think it's going to be pretty interesting.
Love it.
So it's called Black Men Reveal.
I love it. Good. Don't lie, Lenny. Be very revealing. Don't lie.
Okay.
Okay.
No, I keep it real. I think we want to play back Nadia. This is what call that came in earlier. Listen.
Well, no, I don't really feel so. I mean, I was listening to one of the last gentlemen that was speaking with you, and he stated that you just can't get on a bike and know how to ride. I don't really feel so. So I have an instance in my relationship. I've been married over 20 years. Mm-hmm. I'm in my early 40s. Mm-hmm. And, you know, one day we had sex, and, you know, my husband ended up asking me, you know, what got into you? You know, your moans was really outrageous. It was so tender, so sexy, blah, blah, blah. I haven't heard that from you in a long time. And, you know, I just said it was just the moment. But actually, I never cheated on my husband. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I was engulfed in conversation mm-hmm. with a friend that I happened to run across one day, and throughout the time that we were talking, you know, one thing led to another where we ended up having, I guess people will call it phone sex, and spiritually, he touched me in certain ways that mm-hmm. I would say no other man actually touched me in that way physically.
And that was just a conversation.
I guess this guy took more time with me, you know, through the time that we were speaking, you know, outside of everything, you know, trying to rebuild a lot of things that you could say that my husband probably tore apart along the years. Mm-hmm. And just from the understanding, his tenderness, his caring, you know, it just brought out the woman that I always was deep down inside, but just locked away because of how my husband was treating me throughout the years.
That conversation brought out the tigress in you.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. And I felt more like a woman than any other time in my life, to be honest. And this guy has never even touched me. When I'm on Facebook, you know, I try to tell people that sometimes, you know, spiritually, you can connect with somebody in such a better way than physically. And I feel that if you connect with someone on a spiritual level, it's one of the greatest things because you bypass all of that physicalness and you're reaching into someone's soul. Mm. So that's something special right there.
Well, you know what? A lot of people don't understand that. A lot of people don't understand this, Nadine.
No, a lot of people don't understand it.
A lot of people don't understand that sex doesn't really start in the bedroom. It starts in the mind. And if you captivate and stimulate the mind, the bedroom is just a sneeze and a jump away.
Exactly.
So I understand. I get it. I get it. So I'm going to be a little, I just need to ask this one last question.
No.
Do you still have conversation with this young man?
I do, actually. Mm-hmm. I have conversations with him, regular conversations. We haven't played anymore because I think that I was kind of getting a little taken away, and I just had to put a pause on things, I guess, you know, because I was never unfaithful to my husband, and I can see that's where it would have probably led to.
Mm.
So,
I got one more question for you. I got one more question for you, baby. Do you think about him when you're having sex with your husband?
No, I try not to do that. In the beginning, after we was doing the phone sex thing, I used him every once in a while to uplift me in that moment, but it just wasn't work. It didn't work out for me the way a lot of people said that it could. You know, that mind game just didn't work for me. Because they were just two totally different people. And although, you know, I would have been using my husband's body in place of his, you know, I knew that. So it just didn't help at all. So when me and my husband would engage in sex, you know, I have my fantasies that I play with, you know, and things like that, but I would not use him.
Well, Nadine, needless to say,
I don't know if I wanted to be on air anymore.
Look, baby, I thank you for really being upfront and confessing tonight, and I wish you the best of luck with the marriage. I hope, you know, your husband will understand and that he has to, like, kind of step it up a little bit more.
Maybe, maybe not. You know, some men are stuck in a rut.
Yeah, well, the end result is obvious. Mm-hmm. That's all I'm going to say. But thank you for calling. Appreciate you.
Thank you for listening.
Have a good weekend.
Wow.
That was Nadia who became Nadine.
Nadia that became Nadine. And Nadine is in my mind.
Is in my mind, too.
She's Nadine with her boo on the phone, and she's Nadia to her husband.
Somebody's on the line. Hello? Hello, hello.
Hey.
How are you?
Rob from upstate New York here.
Hey, Rob. Hi. How you feel, man?
I'm doing good.
Rob, first of all, let me thank you, man, for coming to the Quiet Storm Midnight Yacht Party last Friday night for singles only. I noticed that you, I saw you on the dance floor, man. I saw you connecting with a couple of young ladies along the night.
Yep, I did.
That's what's up, brother.
Did you make a love connection? Did you go on any dates?
Well, I'm still in the starting stages. Like I said, I went down to the first floor to go sign up for speed dating, and then I was dancing with someone down there, and then I started talking to her outside and exchanged information or contact info. So I'm taking it little by little.
My goodness! Congrats!
Gotta still feel each other out a little bit as you know, learning about each other because you know it only took me about you know maybe we only have like not that much time to talk, but still got a long way to go.
Hey man, you know what? You're doing the right thing. You want to take your time. You don't want to rush it. You just want to be cool with it. You know what I'm saying? Ask her questions. You know, not crazy questions. Just questions to get to know questions. And see how she vibes. And then
I texted her a few days ago, and I basically just said, hey, it was great. Basically commenting on the night. And I'm going to probably try to engage in it. Kind of space it out a little bit. Maybe give like a few days in between. Albeit it's tricky that you know looking at locations where I'm upstate New York and she's down in the obviously in the New York New Jersey area. It's gonna be a little bit of a tricky deal for me. But you know,
make it happen.
Make it work. This is
yeah,
I
man.
Like
you know,
I was talking with her. She was someone I could click with.
Well, man, I'm happy that you met someone, and I hope it goes well. But guess what, man? If it doesn't go well, so be it. There's other many fish in the sea. Trust me.
Yep,
But good. I'm glad that you did your thing.
I go for the wrong one sometimes, but you know, this time I could go for someone that the vibe I felt. You know, maybe it's just me. You know, still buzzing from the moment. But hey, you never know.
You never know.
As I said when I went on the cruise, you never know.
I'm glad that you got that spunk. And you know what? I commend Rob, who came all the way down from upstate New York to be a part of the cruise. And he was really kind of apprehensive. And we had some prior conversations on Facebook. And I'm glad that you were able to,
like he was having fun.
See my point. No, I think he had a great time. You're probably one of the few men on board that did have a good time, aside from me.
I kind of did. I did pretty much. I mean, you know, I tried to do what I had to do and just be you. And, you know, a lot of it, like, especially when I was downstairs, you know, it was the same way. I felt like a lot of people, the funny thing is, it's like, I feel like I lot of people criticize, oh, you have lack of confidence, all this other stuff. I honestly felt like for the first time my confidence kind of came out, and it was almost like natural. I felt more natural than that whole night, you know.
That's good.
Nice.
That means it's a good vibe between both of you. That's good.
Nice.
Yep. Yo, man, thank you, brother. Thank you for reaching out to us tonight. We really appreciate it, Rob.
Yeah, now I was going to chime in on the topic tonight about the obviously the Confessions of Love topic tonight.
So give me your thought.
There's a difference between, you know, being the cutesy, playful, hey, how'd you learn how to do that? Mm. And the, you know, how'd you learn how to do that? And it's almost like, you know, the insecure type.
Mm.
I mean, if you're playful with it, you know, and she's playful with it, it's the same as, you know, being able to take a joke and, you know, and not being able to take a joke. And there's all that difference, you know.
Right.
And that's what I compare it to.
No, I dig where Robert's coming from. It depends on how you say it.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes not what you say, it's how it's said.
It's how it's said, right. Yeah. And especially during sex, like, you don't want to ruin the mood. Like,
why would you do that?
Right. At least get the goodies first and the tricks, the new tricks. And then afterwards, we're like, you know.
Yeah,
I
agree.
Yeah.
Hey, Rob, thanks for calling, man. Have a wonderful weekend, bro.
Thank you. You too, Lenny. And I'll talk to you soon. Maybe I'll see you soon. We'll see what happens. Maybe you never know. Next time you do hold a gig or anything I can come to, you know, maybe I might be able to throw an offer her way to come with me.
Uh-oh.
You never know. We'll see what happens. Like I said, it's long plans ahead. I'm basically just taking it day by day, taking it. It's hard, but I got to do what I got to do.
Exactly. Keep us posted, though.
I will.
Okay.
Later.
Aww, no problem. Cool beans.
Yeah, man.
I love it. See what happens?
It. You never know when it's going to happen.
Okay, can I go back to Nadia? Can I say that Nadia is cheating on her sex partner, too? Or her phone sex partner?
He doesn't. He's irrelevant.
Did you hear what she said? You said, do you think about him when you're having sex with your husband?
Right.
She said, I don't know exactly
what
she said.
She has a few fantasies of herself.
She has, right, she has other things that she fantasizes about. So even without that guy, she's fantasizing. So her husband is just not doing it. What is going on?
But you said she's cheating on the guy. I don't even look at the guy as a relevant factor.
Look, she said it. He touched her soul. So,
in conversation.
So she doesn't want to use the guy that she had phone sex with for her husband's fantasy because she literally said she'd be having her husband's body but having the other guy in her mind and it wouldn't be the same. I listen. But then she's using some other fantasy instead of the guy she had phone sex with and her husband. So her husband is just like tier three altogether.
This is the reality of love. This is Indy Smith, Miss Tier 3. I'm Lenny Green. Thank you for joining us.
Oh, man, got tears.
Oh, we do. I'll be the first to admit that. I'm an emotional. I'm in touch with my emotions.
I didn't say tears. I said tears.
Oh, tears.
Tears, like tears,
of
like
course.
Layers of a cake.
Yeah, yeah. Don't we all? If we're human, don't we all?
When you get older, you should not have that many tears. You should have maybe one or two.
Well, look, you have...
I don't have any tears.
An 18-tier cake.
No, I don't.
One would think that Indy is...
What? Indy is not dating anyone.
I would say
anyone.
Something. No,
Indy
say,
is single. I don't have any tears.
I didn't say... You have tears. You have tears to your personality. Are you kidding me?
Oh, yeah. Right.
Multidimensional. The cake is from the floor to the ceiling. How many tears is that? So
I'm a million-dollar wedding cake.
Exactly. So, you know, you don't give me that. You know, she's... Speaking in double tongue, I don't think as you get old, you shouldn't have any tears. Well, eliminate some of your tears then.
No.
Bring it down to at least three.
No, but I'm not talking about those kind of tears. Don't try to change. You know what? You're not slick. You're not slick. You're trying to change the conversation and change the point. The point I was making was that men have different tiers.
We all do.
You all have certain options, and I'm going to call this one, and this one gets a call at this time.
But so
and this one. No, I don't.
Okay. Indy, stop lying. When you wake up tomorrow morning, if there's a couple of white pimples on your tongue, that means you already told the lie tonight.
I don't have any tears. I'm not dating anyone.
Okay, you're not dating anyone. That doesn't mean that you're not socializing with anyone and you're playing with the word dating. So we don't know if you socialize with a lot of people throughout the course of a day, throughout the course of a week, forget about the course of a month.
Okay.
So a lot of them may have interest in you. You know who you know who has an interest in you. You may not have an interest in them, but you know if if someone has an interest in you. You know.
Right. As of now, from what I know, no one is interested in me to put them in any tier
No one
category.
Who you're interested in. That's interested in you. There may be some people interested in you that you may not be interested in.
Well, can you let me know? Let me know. And I might just reciprocate the interest.
realityoflove@gmail.com. Let her know. realityoflove.
Live.
All one word. live@gmail.com.
Wait, why are we putting it on there? Then you're going to be all in my business.
You check them. I can't even begin to. I set it up. Somebody's on the line.
Who? Kim.
Kim. Okay, so let's get Kim on line two. See what Kim is talking about.
I am drinking
about.
Water, by the way. Did I so tell you I was drinking water?
Hey, Kim,
water?
How are you?
Hi.
Thanks for joining us tonight. Say hello to Indy.
Hi, Indy.
Hi, Kim.
What's your comment?
Oh, I wanted to say that sometimes it doesn't make a difference if she's involved with a person or married to a person. I guess he don't realize there's more than one way of learning positions. Mm-hmm. I mean, she could get a DVD nowadays and watch a video by herself or with a group. She could even watch. She could even look at a book that has pictures and words.
True.
She don't necessarily have to come into contact with a third party to learn positions.
Right.
And then she might have a pastor she never knew about.
A pastor.
A past.
Oh, a past. Oh, she could have a pastor because, you know, they get kinky, too.
Some people don't want to show everything that they know.
Sound point, Kim. Sound
real point. Deep, though. It's real deep.
It is. It really is. But it does happen.
It does.
Thank you for airing it out with us tonight. We appreciate you.
Thank you for taking my call.
That's Kim, ladies and gentlemen. 1-855-453-6699. 94. Shout out to Miss J, Jennifer down in the ATL, who's locked in online with us.
The ATL?
The ATL. Yep. Yep. Oh, we got a lot of people locking in from a lot of parts of the country. So thank you for watching. We do this every week as a way to really get in depth and really kind of go full circle with everything. Next Thursday night, I understand we're going to have a special guest.
Woo!
Gossip Viv.
Oh, yeah. I'm like, don't look. Don't be messing up.
Well,
the
actually,
theme.
You know what? We may have a couple of guests. I'm going to try to convince him to stay.
Oh.
Life Jennings.
Oh.
Life Jennings. He's coming out with a brand new CD, and he's in town. I know he's coming by to engage in Confession of Love. So I'm going to see if I can get him to stick around for a little while longer beyond 10 o'clock so that way we can talk with him. Because all of his albums are really dealing with relationships.
And Scandal, honey.
Okay. Maybe. Yeah. Well, yeah.
That is going to be fun.
Yeah, that should be pretty
Life, Viv, Green, and Indy.
Wow. What a combination.
I'm excited.
You just never know what's going to happen next.
And we have a great topic for next week.
Thanks to Indy. I say we do Truth or Dare, but.
Okay, I was looking at those two for dare. I think we need to come up with our own Truth or Dare questions.
Oh, okay.
Or we could do the Have You Ever game. I love that
one. I like
one.
The Have You Ever.
Have you ever?
We should bring everybody involved with that.
Absolutely.
Vito, Ishay. We should bring everybody.
We should.
One full
and,
party.
No, we should. And we're going to have the shot. We're going to have the shot glasses. And are really going to go in.
Yeah.
Have you ever?
Have you ever? You'll make up the questions because knowing you.
All right.
That would be great.
Oh, my God, no. What's
so you won't really know what to expect next week.
I'm so excited.
And the whole thing with Scandal, obviously, another season of Scandal. I haven't seen one episode of Scandal
I
yet.
Wouldn't say that. I wouldn't even say that. I wouldn't
I'm
let
being honest.
Know
I keep
that.
It real. I'm transparent with it.
Well, then you need to catch up. I'm going to let you hold my DVD for the first season.
Okay. What season were
you gotta in? No, we're in season three.
Wow.
Season three didn't happen. We're going into season three. So you got to catch up.
Next week starts season three. Okay.
Yes.
Got it. Next Thursday. It's Scandal Thursday. Yes, is here on the Reality of Love.
Scandal Thursday.
Wow. Imagine what could happen on camera. Imagine.
We're keeping our clothes on, okay?
Hey, look.
The shots might flow, but we are keeping
our
clothes
on. You could pour a shot on somebody with
your
clothes on.
We're not doing no body shots.
Oh, that's...
We're not in college.
It's Scandal.
Well, I guess I am.
Exactly.
No.
No?
No.
Okay.
Absolutely not.
So standard.
Oh, the breast cancer awareness.
Yes. October 20th. I hope that you will consider joining me. We have the LennyGreen.com team. We're going now. Obviously, October 20th is the National Breast Cancer Awareness Day, where everyone all around the country, and there's so many people that engage into, you know, these walks, and rightfully so. It is a serious and terrible disease.
Yeah.
And I'm just really surprised that, you know, out of all the millions of dollars that has been raised, that we still have yet to find a cure for this.
Right.
I think that's a scandal in itself. To be honest with you, I think
it'd be nice if we could get a medical professional to come up to explain everything and explain I really don't know. It's the test. It's the gene test that Angelina Jolie took. Like, it just goes to show you that people that are financially more comfortable can afford certain things. But that test is apparently really expensive, but it's definitely necessary. Just like a mammogram is necessary, I think that test is necessary, and women need to see if the gene is in it. You know, it's just knowledge, but I don't know much about it, and I think it would be really dope if we could get somebody up here that knows in depth what it means, what the stages mean, you know?
Yeah, and it would also be nice if we can get someone to expound on breast cancer with men.
Yes.
I met a brother recently. He starts up this. Matter of fact, I'll try to get him in here too. He starts up this whole campaign to bring awareness about men having breast cancer. As a matter of fact, there's a renowned actor who we all know, the original Shaft, Richard Roundtree.
Richard Roundtree.
He was diagnosed with breast cancer.
Oh.
Obviously, he's still living because it was early detection. He caught it in time. But it would be great if we can try to somehow get him to call in as well, because it's not, the cases aren't as high in men as it is in women, but just by the mere fact that it does exist is alarming.
Well, I mean, I don't know this. I'm not a medical professional, but I don't understand, and I want to ask a professional this. I don't understand what a cure would actually do. Does it prevent you from getting it at all, or does it just cure it immediately without a chemo? Because I was under the assumption that cancer is actually, we have cancer cells already in our body.
Right.
Now, whether or not they develop depends on a bunch of other things. So isn't that a natural thing if it's already in your body?
Yeah,
there's no such thing as like getting rid of cancer.
Right.
Maybe it's not.
But is it treatable? Right. And I think that's the remedy of it.
Okay. You know,
can it be treatable? And is it treatable to the level where it can totally be eliminated?
Eliminated.
At least that particular.
Getting rid of the cells altogether in your body?
Well, that particular cell that is, you know, detrimental to your health.
Okay.
I mean, if we can just get to that level. Can we get to that level? There has to be a young scientist out there.
Exactly.
Who really knows. So I just pray that we do find a cure for it. My auntie, before she transitioned, she didn't transition because of it, but she did have two vasectomies.
Yes.
So it definitely has affected my family and
my mom too. She had two. Okay. She's a survivor, and
God is amazing. So look, make sure you get checked, and ladies, encourage your men to get checked, not only for breast cancer but prostate. That's more higher, obviously.
Right.
You know, with men.
Well, it's your reproductive organ. So I wonder if that plays a part also.
Very well, maybe.
You know.
I think so. It very well might. There's some shows coming up that I do want to kind of give a commercial on real quick. I think I'm good. Well, I know there's one show in particular in November, Black Friday, actually, that I'm going to be a part of, and that is the show that stars Avant, Music Soul Child, and Brian McKnight. It's going to be
great VIP section. I just know it. No?
It's going to be
For Joe. Don't even.
It's going to be at the Beacon Theater on Black Friday, which I think is November 29th. Here's the deal. Because you're watching tonight and you want to go, tickets go on sale on Saturday. So tomorrow, if you want to go and get tickets, only you know this because everyone doesn't know this. If you're following me on any of my social streams, then you might know. The password, the code word is Dallas BBQ. If you go to Ticketmaster.com. Are you okay? She's having a special moment. If you go to Ticketmaster.com, the promotional code word is DallasBBQ, and you can... Are you all right? You can get your tickets tomorrow before they go on sale on Saturday. I guarantee a sellout, though. But it's Black Friday, November 29th, the day right after Thanksgiving. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm just thinking of the sticky wings and BBQs and the pineapple crush
that
I like.
See?
What? That's what I like in BBQs.
First thing she thought
I thought of chicken.
Well, sticky wings.
Sticky wings. Oh, my goodness. Really? Really? I thought of the damn sticky wings and my pineapple crush. I love it. It's like
pineapple crush is the...
Because it's like BBQ.
You lost it.
I just had a moment. I had a moment.
You had
Hi,
a
Rich.
Climactic moment.
Yes, I did.
I know. So please come to that, Rich.
Hey, you never know. You get there, maybe after the show, me and you could go for sticky wings.
There is a Dallas BBQ not far from the Beacon Theater.
72nd Street. Over near the park.
Near the park, exactly. She knows where her...
I know where
sticky
the food
wings
is.
Are.
Yes,
that's
I
for
do.
Sure. I'm not mad at you. All right, Indy. Mm-hmm. Okay.
What's another show? You said a couple.
There's another show. October 18th out in Long Island. It's Gladys Knight in Mint Condition. Mm. That's an interesting combination, right?
It is.
Mint Condition and Gladys Knight. And then November 9th, Patti LaBelle and Elle DeBarge.
Wow.
Out in Westbury, Long Island. Both of those are out in Westbury, Long Island. And next Friday, the last smooth jazz cruise of the season.
Aww.
A tribute to Angela Beaufil.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Who's rocking on that one?
Mesa. Wonderful. You remember, if you know the jazz group Incognito, mm-hmm. She was the female vocalist for Incognito for a long time. Mesa, saxophonist Dave, no, Kim Waters. Angela Beaufil would be there, though. But, you know, Angie can't really perform
she's
like she used
singing.
To.
She's not singing. What she about talks. Vocally?
Yeah,
like,
she,
vocally,
well, she,
talk,
she tells the stories
okay.
of how certain songs came up. So,
love her voice.
Oh, yeah. Beautiful. And she's from the Bronx, and, you know, we love her. And we thank God for bringing her this far. You know, she was challenged with a couple of strokes over the years,
mm-hmm.
and it kind of hurt her. Obviously, her musical career from recording further. So that's pretty much all on the list. But please go to LennyGreen.com. We have a newly designed website. Mm-hmm. Indy is starting to contribute.
You have jokes?
More. No, Indy. She's contributing, so you'll see.
Shout out to AJ. Thank you, AJ, for all your support.
That sounds like a prepared speech.
No.
She has news articles, entertainment news, and there's news about political, social issues. There's... any of the interviews that you may have missed, there's a few up there, including the Cheryl Lee Ralph interview that she was just here last night. Right.
Mm-hmm.
So if you missed that, please go there. And just a newly refreshed website, LennyGreen.com, that we hope that you find interesting and engaging. So please, once you get that information, please hit us back and let us know what you think about it. I think you'll be able to engage in conversation with Indy or comment to Indy on the site as well.
Mm-hmm.
And Indy is very proactive when it comes to a lot of stuff, even though she's holding down school and a lot of other things, right?
Yes, that's okay.
That's excellent. Even though she says she's not dating.
No, do I have time?
I don't know.
Oh.
You know?
No tears, no cake. I don't have any cake yet. I need some cake.
She has cake. Cake, yeah.
Cake. I need some
We're
male cake.
We're
going to
talk about that moment.
Male cake, please. This is a good one. Nadia... Yes, girl. Yes. I understand the spiritual connection.
I want to thank Ms. Ishe White for contributing in a great way tonight, as she always does on Thursday nights. So thank you very much for doing that. And we hope that you will, you know,
come back. Come back next week. It's going to be turned up for real.
I want to know how it's going to be turned up. Are you, what are you wearing?
Not
grandma.
Really?
You can't wear grandma clothes.
Why not?
Because
I'm coming in a freaking sweatsuit.
Because,
how about that?
Because Kerry Washington on the series.
Okay, so I'm so going to do my Kerry Washington. I am going to make sure I am Kerry Washington. Don't.
I mean, please. I mean, you know why? Because,
there.
Well, look.
Don't take me there.
I remember one time, and if you are a regular watcher of this show,
are
one time.
There? Are we really
going
there?
Yeah, we're going
that
there.
That wasn't Kerry
Washington.
She
went, like, she came in so dressed up.
I wasn't dressed
I
up.
I felt like a bum.
I wasn't dressed up.
The attire that she wore here, she could have worn to any black tie affair.
Nobody would wear that to no damn black tie affair. That was some little skimpy dress, and I just look cute.
Now,
that was
you
not
know you've
red
been
carpet.
To one of those formal affairs.
That
and,
is hood ladies, rat when you carpet.
No. It wasn't hood rat. It was extremely sexy. And look, I'm not getting in depth of why you came in like that. I'm just saying you came in like that. So
is that a laugh?
I know, I know, and obviously Rich knows how you did what you did. I don't know if Rich was here, but hey, look, turn it up like that. If you're going to turn
I'm
it up,
I'm not turning it up like that. It's wintertime. It's cold outside.
Oh, she didn't come. Oh, you thought she came into the studio like that from the outside? Oh, no, not this one. No, no, no. The dress was packed up in a bag, ladies and gentlemen.
It's 11:58.
And then she went to,
good night,
she went
God
to the
bless.
Bathroom, came back, and she went like, Indy, you didn't come here like this. What the heck is going
I
on?
I wouldn't be in the best.
Nothing. Glossed up, lipstick up, eyeshadow, eyelash that they stood out to here, the whole nine. So, look, if you're going to do the scandal thing for next week, at least.
I'm not going to dress like that. Carrie would not dress like that, and I'm not going
to
do
look,
that.
Look, I've saw little highlights. I never saw the show,
you
but
need
I've seen
to catch
highlights.
Up. You don't even need to talk about the show until you catch up, okay? At least get season one under your belt.
No problem. I will definitely do
you
that by next Thursday. I will have season one underneath the belt. That's going to do it for us this week. Thank you so much for engaging in conversation. We hope that you've enjoyed yourself. Shout out to Mama Jones. Mama Jones, we're going to get Mama Jones on this show. I don't know exactly when. Mama Jones is going to keep it real.
Yeah.
She has a book coming out on October 18th called Love and Romance.
She don't have fans. She got people. Please don't say you're a fan.
Don't say you're a fan.
Don't.
Because Mama will definitely
jab
you.
Yeah.
Next week, y'all, we'll see you on Scandalous Thursdays inside of The Reality of Love. But until then, adios.